come back to the next session on load and store instruction. Now we are working with we discuss about multiple register transfer. Earlier session we discuss about single register transfer, because we are copying the data from memory to processor register. Any one register we are copying it, loading it, or storing from one register to the memory location pointed by any base register. Now we are working with more than one register now. Okay. Look at one example. Look at the instruction LDM. LDM means load multiple register. Nothing but you are loading the data from memory to ARM register, not only one register, more than one register. That's why name is given multiple register. Same thing for STM. Okay. STM. Save multiple register. Nothing but from more than one register content we are transferring to the memory. Okay. If you write LDR single register, STR single register. That is. If you write M multiple register, more than one register. And if you are working with more than one register, now we need to keep in mind that these things: increment after, increment before, decrement after, and decrement before. Okay, so what is meaning of increment after and increment before, then decrement after and before? Okay, its meaning is that I'll look at one example of increment after. So what pointer you are using it? It is applicable for LDM also and STM. Okay. If let assume that you are working with LDM. Okay. After copying the first, you copy the data from memory to processor register, then increment the pointer. Okay. First nothing but increment after. After meaning is first copy it, then increment. Exactly opposite before. First increment the pointer, then copy it. So nothing but before copying we should increment. In case of after copying we increment the pointer. Similarly, if you are decrementing the pointer, so use decrement before and decrement after, you can use it. Okay, now how we can declare the these things, the multiple registers. Now this is the way of declaring multiple registers. Multiple register, to declare it in flower bracket. Okay, you can define the range or you can use comma to separate out. In flower bracket you have to declare R1 hyper indicate R3 indicate. You need to copy the data to three register, R1, R2 and R3, from memory to the these three register. If you can separate out by with comma, comes R1, R5 and R7. So copy data to R1, comma R5, then comma R7. Okay. Comma is to separate out. Okay. Hyphen is used for the range. Okay. Now look at one example of LDMI, increment after now. Now look at carefully before earlier before execution of this LDMI instruction and after execution, nothing but pre and post. This is pre and this is post. Okay, now these are the content of R0, R1, R2 and R3. R1, R2, R3 are initially R00, and you are using R0 as a pointer with the write back symbol is there, nothing but it should update the pointer. Okay. Now the content of memory. R0 is pointing at memory address of 80010. Here you are. R0 is pointing here. Okay. Then next memory location. In that memory location 1 is stored. Next memory location 2. Next 3. So we are working with 32-bit data. Okay, so after 10, 14, 18 is used. Okay. Now we'll look into the with the help of diagrammatic arrangement. Okay. Look at the carefully. And the diagram shows that the R0 initially pointing at this memory now. Okay. So what we'll do it during execution of LDMI, first we'll copy the content of current memory pointed by R0 to register R1. It copied sequentially R1, R2 and R3. Okay. So first copy it R1. Then after copying it, R0 will point to the increment it and point to the next memory. That's why it's increment after first copy it, then increment point to the next memory. Okay. Then it will copy to the R2, next memory content. Similarly, it will copy next content to the R3 and stops its copying it, because only three registers are mentioned here. Okay. And even after execution, you can observe that in the instruction we have used the explanatory symbol. So what is the meaning of that? If you remove this explanatory symbol, it will remains at its earlier or initial values, that is 80010. If you put the explanatory symbol, it will update with the new address, that is 80018. I'll show this one also in an example. Now you can observe that here. It will point to the new or last updated value from the memory, that is 80010. Okay. Same thing you can use it for the increment before also. Increment before, first it will not copy. First increment the pointer, then copy it. You can observe that here also. The same values are there. The R1 is not copied 1 1. In the previous example, it copied 1 1 1. Now it copied 2. Nothing but first increment pointer. That's why increment before it says that. Increment, copy from that memory location. Then it will R2 will copy 3, R3 will copy 4, and R0 will update to the 1C. Okay. Now look at the earlier previous example. The after execution R0 value is the same thing, but the content of the R1, R2, R3 get changed. You can observe that here. R1, R2, R3. In the previous one, it is 1, 2, 3, and next one is 2, 3, 4. Okay, that is the only change in this LDMIA and LDMIB. Increment after and increment before. Same thing applicable for the decrement after and decrement. Here the pointer is incrementing, there in that pointer is decrementing. Okay, so no need to explicitly mention. Okay. Now LDMIB and LDMIA, the same thing we can apply for decrement after and decrement before. Okay. Now I'll move on to the same this technique you can use for in case of working up stack or functionality of stack, how we can you work for push and pop. There is no explicit instructions are there in ARM where you can use direct push and pop to work and support in the stack. Even there is no explicit default stack is available in the ARM. User has to define the stack. Okay. So using this LDM, STM, we can implement the stack working. I'll move on to stack part now. Push and pop. Okay. Stack can be grown in either ascending order or descending order. Nothing but incrementing order or decrementing order. It depends on the location of the stack pointer. Okay. So in the stack, if you are working, you will come across a full stack and empty stack. Full stack indicate that complete stack memory allocated, completely filled with the data. Empty stack, nothing is there in that stack memory, or all the data is taken out, okay, or retrieved out from the stack. So using this ascending and descending, if ascending you are using as a stack, so the stack pointer incrementing to higher memory location. Descending order stack decrementing to the lower memory addresses. Okay. Now there are two things we will come across. FA, nothing but full and empty. So we'll combine with the ascending and descending. Full ascending, full descending, empty ascending, empty descending. It is applicable for LDM and STM. Okay. LDM are used to work as a pop instruction. STM you are going to use as a push, because going to write into the stack. Okay. Here you can observe that LDM FA, full ascending, FD, full descending, empty ascending, empty descending. So nothing but the stack on a pointer, whether you want ascending order or descending order. Nothing but incrementing ascending or incrementing pointer is required, or decrementing stack pointer. That's why it is ascending and descending. Now in case of push, STM full ascending, STM full descending, empty ascending and empty descending. Okay. Now look at some working of this. Okay. Now look at the working of STM FD. Okay. Now we are using the explicit stack pointer SP, explanatory symbol. What is the use of explanatory symbol? It will update to the last retrieved value of the pointer now. Instead of register, you are using stack pointer. We can use the R13 pointer also, because it is a, also we can use as a stack pointer also, you can use it. Instead of SP, you can write R13 also. Now here, these are the initial content of stack pointer. You can observe that even the content of register. Now you are pushing some data from register R1 and R4 to the memory pointed by stack pointer. Okay. Now here use the not only STM, FD is there. FD means full descending. Okay. Now when it will push the data to stack from the content of R1, you can observe that initially stack pointer here, and it is in the descending order. Now we are decrementing it. Stack pointer decrementing. So content of first R4 is copied to the memory 80010. Okay. After copying, stack pointer decremented. Okay. Then it will copy the content of R1, that is 2, to the memory location 800C. So it might become 2. Okay. Now after that, pushing all data or transferring data from R4 and R1 to the stack. Now stack is full now. Nothing further data can be added into the stack. So indicate that full descending, it stopped it. Okay. Or in simple word, the stack pointer does not point to the next memory address. It will point at the same memory address where it is data, last data is pushed into that. Okay. That is the main use of full descending. Now in case of empty descending, just replace F by E, empty. The same thing, it only point to the empty location. Now you can observe that here. It will point to the next memory address, which is empty. Okay. Empty location. Now in earlier example, it is pointing at the same memory location. You can observe that here. And in case of empty, it will pointing at the next memory location where there nothing is there in that, nothing is stored, completely empty memory location. So that stack pointer point to the next empty location. That is indicate the empty descending. If it pointing at the current data store value, that is full descending. The same thing applicable for the empty ascending and empty full ascending also. Now we move on to the next part of the basics stack. If you are working with the stack, you must need the stack base. You need to initialize stack pointer must initialize, and you must know the stack limit, nothing but the size of stack, because based on that size of stack we can say that it is full or any overflow or any underflow also. Okay, the stack base provide with the underflow and stack limit provide with the overflow. Okay, now we'll move on to next instruction, that is swap instruction. The swap is nothing but in simple word you can say that exchange of instruction from one memory location to register and register to the same memory location. Okay, you can use in short SWP. Swap is basically, this is used for the transfer of exchange of 32-bit information. Swap SWPB is used for the byte, only byte, that 8 bit of data get exchange. Now look at one example. Okay. Now here you can observe that content of the memory pointed by R2, that is, this is 930s. This number get copied to register R0, and content of R1, the middle register, copied to the memory pointed by R2. Nothing but same memory location. Okay, I can observe that here, pre and post. Okay, so R0 is initially, it can be 0 or it can be any other value also. That also you can use it. Okay, move on to next one. That is the software interrupt instruction, SWI. This software instruction usually used to call the operating system routines, predefined routines are there. So that's why if you are working with operating system, then you can use the SWI. Okay. And this SWI usually works in the supervisor mode, where some operating system already installed. Now usually it will call some software instruction number. Okay, there are predefined numbers are there. Every operating system having different software instruction numbers are there. That is depends on what operating system are using it. And it can be different for Windows, it can be different for Linux based, it can be different for Macintosh based. If you are ARM, if you are using in Android, the Android are different. Or if you are working with Apple based, Apple have different. Okay, it depends on the which operating system. Okay. Usually it works in the supervisor mode. Now come to the program status register. Nothing but whether we can able to copy the content of SPSR and CPSR to any other register, or from register to CPSR or SPSR. SPSR usually works in different processor modes, but most of the CPSR is used, current program status register. Okay. Now, two instructions are used. One is MRS. Next one is MSR. MRS means move the content of status register to the any general purpose register in the ARM. Nothing but R1, R2, R3, R0 or any other register. The S indicate here CPSR or can be SPSR. Okay. Exactly opposite MSR. Okay. Move content of register to the status register. Register can be R0 to R13. Then that will copy to either CPSR or SPSR. Okay. Now come to the last part of the this second module, that is coprocessor instruction. The coprocessor instruction, nothing but whether we want to perform some mathematical or floating point operation you are working on it. The coprocessor instructions are widely used. Then these are the few instructions. There are many instructions are there, but even textbook here given only three. And that is CDP, coprocessor data processing, perform some operation in the coprocessor. MRC, MCR, nothing but transfer the status register to the coprocessor or register to the coprocessor. Then transfer between ARM register content to the coprocessor register. Same thing, load and store also we can use it. From coprocessor memory transfer, the block of memory from coprocessor to the any other memory or memory to the coprocessor. So the LDC and STC are used. So here wherever C is written, that indicate you are working with the coprocessor. There is no much discussion on coprocessor. Okay. Then move on to the next, that is how we can define the constants. If you are working with LDR, you can use equal to symbol to copy the address of variable also, or copy some constant number, like it can be hexadecimal number, binary number, or any other decimal number also you can copy. Even you can use ADR. ADR means address register. Okay, load address of pseudo instruction. Okay, pseudo instruction nothing but any variable or any name labels you are used in your program. So from that variable address you can copy with the ADR, but during program you can use only LDR, LDR RD comma equal to variable name. Instead of constant you can write the variable name. Okay, that also you can use it. Okay, next one is these are the some few example. We can copy hexadecimal number, or here it is hexadecimal number TFF. Here we are copying same hexadecimal number. Here also You can use the program counter with the constant offset also you can use it. Okay, these are some few examples. Okay, now I'll move on to some assembler directives. Okay, so how to write assembly, how it can be optimized it. Okay, I'll go and brief, I'll just brief out it. I'll not go in detail because very few things are used during programming. Okay, now this is the well-known part. The instruction having three fields are there: label field, instruction field, and operand field. Then fourth one is optional, that is comment field also. Okay, this is well known for you people. Okay, label field, destination, source, and instruction, and then comment field. This is one simple example of how we can write the program. We need to declare the ROM area and RAM area. You can place some data only for reading. You can place for some reserved space is nothing but we need to reserve the 255 memory locations or 255 numbers, 32-bit numbers. I want to store it. That many I reserved it. Space means we are reserved 32-bit memory location. Here 255 32-bit numbers are reserved. Okay, all 255 numbers are 32-bit. The area directive, you know that basically used to whether you are working with the code or data, so you can mention that one. You can data allocation already discussed a few, that is DCD for define constant double word, also constant word, constant byte, constant quad word, space, and fill. Okay, but also you can use it. These are some few example. You can write some string instruction, decimal or floating also you can use it. It can be different type, 32-bit, 8-bit, 8-bit, 32-bit. Space is usually of byte type. It allocate 255 bytes of zero memory locations. Okay, in nothing but each 255 bytes stored, 00 is stored. Okay, then end etiquette, end of the program or further it will not, your agile compiler further will not be translated. Okay, entry the beginning of any main program. Align basically used to align the 16-bit data. Sometimes you're going to work with different kinds of data types. It can be 8-bit, it can be 16-bit, 32-bit, mix of it. To while accessing, by default ARM always usually access the 32-bit information. So if you want to access it properly byte wise or word wise or double word wise, so align is basically used to align it properly. Okay, so optimization also we can do it by some internal inbuilt methods are used. Okay, now for example here we can, the features are there: conditional execution, multiple register load store, you can use scale register operand, some different addressing mode we can use to optimize it. Okay, now optimize nothing but we need to, it's not the code size is smaller or larger, it's not like that. It, you have to take care that what kind of pipelining architecture you're using, or how many pipelining stages are there, 3-stage pipeline or 5-stage, 9-stage or 6-stage pipelines are there. You should not fill up at, if the pipe is completely filled and get struck by some conditional instruction, so nothing but again you have to flush out all the pipes and re-again load with the new addresses. So it takes time consuming. So to avoid that, those conditions, so optimization usually followed it. Okay, so this much is the part covered in second module. Okay, so next I'll start with the third module. Thank you.